الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. We begin with the praise of Allah. We ask and beseech Allah to send His peace and blessings upon His final messenger, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, upon His family, His companions, and all those who follow His way until the Day of Judgment. We ask Allah to make us amongst them. Alhamdulillah, we begin with lesson number 17 of the Islamic Learning Foundation program, Revelation Revealed, Access to Quranic Arabic. In this lesson, inshallah, we will be covering the story of Ibrahim and Qasas al-Nabiyeen, chapters 3 and chapters 4. So without further ado, we will begin, inshallah. So this chapter is entitled Nasihatu Ibrahim. And so here we will put the harakat, the tashkil, na, si, hatu, Ibrahim. So what kind of compound is this? Nasihatu Ibrahim. First, before we go into that, let's go ahead and translate each word. Nasihatu comes from nasuha. Nasuha yansihu. Nasuha means to give advice or to give counsel. Right, so ad-deenu nasiha, right? The hadith of the Prophet, peace be upon him, the deen, the religion, is nasihatun. Nasiha means to give advice or to give counsel. It's obviously a very deep word, but in this context, it means the advice of Ibrahim. And so, what kind of compound is this? This is a possessive compound. And the reason, or this, the hints that indicate that this is a possessive compound, is that the word nasihatu does not have alif lam and it does not have tanween. Whenever you see that, it should raise your ears a little bit. And oftentimes, more than not, this is the mudaf. This is the possessed item in a possessive compound. If you remember, the possessed item comes first, the possessor comes second. The rules for the possessed item or possessed word is that it does not have alif lam and it does not have tanween. And the rule for the possessor, right, the mudafun ilay, in this case, is Ibrahim, is that it takes the state of jar. Now the question then is, why does Ibrahim have a fatha at the end? Well, if you recall, we discussed briefly that there's a category of isms called al-mamnu' min as-sarf or ghayr musarrif, right? These are isms that have special rules. And the basic special rule for these isms is that they do not have alif lam and that they do not have kasra ever. So they do not have tanween and they never take kasra. So the sign for jar, for mamnu' min sarf, is the fatha. So it's a special category of isms that when they are in the state of jar, they have a fatha at the end and they never take the tanween. Well, what are these? There's multiple different rules that indicate that a word takes the mamnu' min sarf. But the one that implies here, and we've talked about before, are names, proper names that are foreign to the Arabic language. They're not originally Arabic. So the name Ibrahim is actually not an Arabic name. It's another name. I'm sure historically you can figure that out. But Ibrahim here is not aslan. It's not in its very essence an Arabic name. And so therefore, this word, Ibrahim, takes the state, is called mamnu' min as-sarf. So mamnu' min as-sarf means that when it's in the state of jar, in this case, it is in the state of jar because it is the mudafun ilay. It is the possessor of the word nasiha. It's the advice of Ibrahim. So Ibrahim is the possessor. And because of that, it's in the state of jar. And the sign of indicating it's in the state of jar is the fatha here because it is mamnu' min as-sarf. Okay, we'll continue inshallah. وَكَانَ إِبْرَاهِيمُ يَقُولُ لِوَالِدِهِ. So like we said previously, we're going to translate each word individually. What means and. Kana, remember, turns whatever comes next into the past tense. So we'll ignore it in the beginning and then we'll bring it back to make everything in the past. Ibrahimu. So Ibrahim is the ismu kana. It's the name. It is the subject here. He is the subject here. Yaqulu liwalidihi. So yaqulu is a verb. It's a deficient verb because it has a waw in it. You see that waw there? And it comes basically from qala. Let me change the keyboard to my keyboard. So qala yaqulu. All right, qala yaqulu. And qala yaqulu, as we know, means to say. So yaqulu is present tense form of qala. So Ibrahim qala. So again, this is one of those deficient verbs that has special rules because it has an alif or a waw in it. And we're not going to go into that at this time. But just know that qala is a past tense, huwa. Yaqulu is a present tense, huwa. So Ibrahim yaqulu, if we take the kana out, we say Ibrahim is saying li. Li is a harf jar. That means to. Walidihi. Walid is the opposite of walad. Walad is the child. Walid is the father. So Ibrahim is saying to his father. Walidihi. So walidihi. We have an attached pronoun he, right? And it's attached to an ism. When you have a pronoun attached to an ism, what is its function in the sentence? It is the mudafun ilay. And walidihi is a possessive compound. So the question is, why isn't that waliduhu? Well, because walid is harf jar, takes the state of jar, because it follows a harf jar. So walid, therefore, is going to have a kasra at the end. Now, it's not walidihu because of pronunciation rules. Remember, whenever you have a pronoun, a ha, with a dhamma, typically with a dhamma on it, but it's preceded by a kasra or a ya, then it takes a kasra at the end. So it's li walidihi. Normally it would be waliduhu, but it's li walidihi because walid takes the state of jar because it follows a harf jar. And because there's a kasra before this ha that normally would have a dhamma on it, it takes a kasra in order to make the pronunciation. It's the rules of pronunciation, if you remember. So what is this sentence now? And Ibrahim was regularly saying to his father. Why did I say regularly saying? Because when you have kana and yaqulu, when you have yaqulu, as you know, is a present tense verb. But when you say kana yaqulu, right? When you say kana yaqulu, it now turns it, instead of saying Ibrahim qala li walidihi, Ibrahim said in one point of time to his father. That would be if Ibrahim qala li walidihi. But because it's kana yaqulu, it is a sense that he would regularly say in the past to his father. So Ibrahim used to say is one way you could say it. Or Ibrahim was saying to his father. Meaning repeatedly saying to his father. Ya Abi. So Ya is a word that means you're calling to somebody. So a lot of times it's like, oh. Like, oh, so and so. That's usually how it's translated. So Ya Abi. It's like you're calling out. It's called the al-munadi, right? It's you're calling out, or this is called haf nida. It's you're calling out to somebody. So yeah means you're calling out to somebody. Abi. Abi is the combination of abun, right? Abun. Abun. And, right? Yeah, the ya is the attached pronoun that means me. So, oh my father, wa kana, ya abi, oh my father. So, abi is an, again, when you have an attached pronoun to an ism, it becomes a possessive compound. So, oh my father, limada ta'abudu hadha al-asnama. So, remember, limada is one of the ism istifham. These are one of the isms that ask that are for questions, or these are one of the asma istifhama. These are the asma. These are the words that you put in the beginning of a phrase or a sentence, and it turns that sentence into a question. So if you remove limada and you just say ta'budu hadhihi al-asnama, ta'budu comes from abada, abada ya'budu, abada ya'budu. So abada ba. Da ya'budu. Right? Abada ya'budu means to worship, right? Or to serve. Ta'budu is what? Who's doing the action? Anta ta'budu. You are worshiping. Hadhihi al-asnama. These asnam. These idols or these, stones, right? These idols. So you are worshiping these idols is a statement. When you put limada in front of it, it becomes a question. why are you worshiping these idols? All right? And al-asnama here, what is the grammatical state of al-asnama? It is in the state of nasab. How do you know it's in the state of nasab? Well, you know it's in the state of nasab because it has the sign that indicates it is fatha. And why is it in the state of nasab? Because it is the object of the verb ta'budu. Right? Ta'budu. It's the maf'ulun bihi, the object of the verb. Okay, let's continue. And ya abi limadha tasjudu li hadhihi al-asnam? So same format, so we'll continue quicker now. And oh my father, limadha, why tasjudu? What does tasjudu come from? This is a review. Tasjudu comes from sajada. Sajada yasjudu. What does sajada mean? To make sujood, to make prostration. Who's doing the action here? Anta tasjudu. So why are you prostrating li hadhihi al-asnami, to these idols? وَيَا أَبِي لِمَاذَا تَسْأَلُ هَذِهِ الْأَصْنَامَ. Again, this is a review of the verbs we covered last time. تَسْأَلُ comes from سَأَلَ. سَأَلَ يَسْأَلُ. سَأَلَ means to ask a question. And in this case, is asking the asnam for help. Okay? So, وَيَا أَبِي, and my father, لِمَاذَا, why, تَسْأَلُ, are you asking هَذِهِ الْأَصْنَامَ, these idols? I mean, why are you asking them for help? إِنَّ هَذِهِ الْأَصْنَامَ لَا تَتَكَلَّمُ وَلَا تَسْمَعُ. Indeed, these idols. Okay, so what is the grammatical state of idols here? Al-Asnama. It is in the state of Nasab. How do you know? What's the sign? The Fatha. Why is it in the state of Nasab? Because it follows إِنَّ. إِنَّ وَأَخَوَاتُهَا. Alright? إِنَّ لَكِنَّ لَعَلَّ لَيْتَ. Right? These are the asma, or these are the inna, these are the akhawat, these are the sisters of inna. And all of them, they have their different meanings, but functionally, they turn the word after it into the state of nasab. And because hadhihi al-asnama is like a kind of a they work as a team, just for the sake of simplicity, inna functions on the asnama. Okay. La tatakallamu. So la, remember, is how you negate a present tense verb. And tatakallamu is an enhanced verb. It comes from takallama. Alright? Takallama. Lama. Ya. Takallamu. Takallama ya takallamu. And this is an enhanced verb. Its root is kalama. Kalama. Kalama is speech. Takallama is to speak. Takallama. Alright? Takallama is to speak. Yatakallamu. It's an enhanced verb. What's an enhanced verb? We're going to study it later. But an enhanced verb is when you take the root, the three-letter root, kalama, and you add another lam to it, and you add a ta to it. So there's two letters added to this, to the original root, and so it becomes takallama. That's the past tense, is takallama. And then it becomes yatakallamu for the present tense. وَإِنَّ هَذِي الْأَصْنَامَ. So, إِنَّ هَذِي الْأَصْنَامَ لَا تَتَكَلَّمُ. And then, why is it, who is doing the action here? هِيَ تَتَكَلَّمُ. هِيَ تَتَكَلَّمُ. And, you know, I encourage you, when you're thinking, or when I ask you, and you think to yourself, who's doing the action here? I don't want you to say, like, those plural females. No, I want you to say, هِيَ. I want you to use the dhamir, the pronoun. So, who's doing the action here? هِيَ. لَا تَتَكَلَّمُ. لَا هِيَ تَتَكَلَّمُ. Why is it hiya? It's hiya because al-asnama is a non-human plural. And non-human plurals function like single females. So hiya la tatakallamu wala hiya tasma'u. Tasma'u comes from sami'a. Sami'a yasma'u. Sami'a means to hear. So indeed, these idols do not speak and do not listen or hear. وَإِنَّ هَذِي الْأَصْنَامَ, and indeed these idols, لَا تَضُرُّ وَلَا تَنْفَعُ. Again, review. ضَرَّ يَضُرُّ. And this is a special type of verb because it has a shadda on it. And it comes from ضَرَرَ. And ضَرَرَ means to harm. So they do not harm. وَلَا تَنْفَعُ. تَنْفَعُ comes from نَفَعَ يَنْفَعُ. نَفَعَ means to benefit. And they do not benefit. So this next sentence is one of the more complicated sentences in our readings today. وَلِأَيِّ شَيْءٍ تَضَعُ لَهَا الطَّعَامَ وَالشَّرَابَ. So let's look at this. So what means and? Li means to. أَيِّ شَيْءٍ. أَيِّ شَيْءٍ. When we look at أَيِّ شَيْءٍ, it's actually أَيُّ. It starts from أَيُّ. أَيُّ. أَيُّ شَيْءٍ. in. Okay? أي شيء. So أي شيء means which, like which thing. So أي means which. Whenever you have it, like أي, أي means which. W-H-I-C-H, which, okay? Shay'in means thing, okay? So ayu means, so when, so the meaning, ayu means which, but what ayu does functionally is that it turns the word after it into the state of jar. So ayu will always look like ayu. It's not ayun, ayin, because it's always attached to another word. The word after it is always attached to it. And it takes the state of jar, and it's a mudafun il. It basically takes a possessive compound, you know, method. So ayu shay'in. So shay'in means, ayu means which, shay'in means thing. And shay'in takes the state of jar because it follows ayu, and it's a mudafun il. It's a possessive compound, okay? Now, going back to our sentence here, ayyi shay'in. Remember, just like a mudaf, any possessed item, it could take different grammatical states. And the possessor, the shay here, it takes only the state of jar. So li ayyi shay'in, it's ayyi shay'in because it follows li, which is harf jar. So ayyi is in the state of jar because it follows harf jar. Shay'in is in the state of jar because it follows ayyi, and it is a possessor or mudafun ilay. Okay, and to which thing tada'u laha? So tada'u comes from wada'a. يضعوا وضع ع يضعوا. Again, this is another more complicated verb because it has a wow in the beginning. And when you turn it to the present tense, you'll learn the rules later down in intermediate stage of Arabic. وضع becomes يضعوا. The wow disappears. Okay? So وضع means to put. Put tada'u laha. So sometimes verbs, when you look at handswear, for example, you may see that sometimes verbs, the handswear will have like a it'll have an ism a harf jar after the verb, and it gives a certain meaning. Okay. Well, this is one of those verbs that's usually combined with a harf jar after it. Okay. And so when you put wada'a li means to put for, like for something, okay? Or to do it for this reason, or to give something to somebody, basically, right? So wada'u laha. So li ayyi shay'in wada'u laha. And for which thing are you putting for it? And ha here means it, not her, means it. And it's referring for it, meaning the aslam. Because we're talking about aslam, which both the communicator and the one being communicated to knows what we're talking about. You can now use the damir ha, because we know we're talking about a non-human plural item, which is asnam. So li ayyi shay'in tada'u laha, and for which thing are you putting for it at-ta'ama wash-sharab, and for, it's for them because we're talking about plural asnam, right? Li ayyi shay'in tada'u laha at-ta'ama wash-sharab. At-ta'am means food, sharab means drink. And ta'am is in what grammatical state? And the same thing. Oopsies. Sharab is in the same grammatical state. They're both in the state of nasab. Why are they in the state of nasab? Or how do we know? The fatha. Why? Because they're the maf'ulun bihi of tada'a, which means to put. Okay? And so for which thing are you putting for it? At-ta'am and sharab. Food and drink. Meaning like you're giving, you're offering food and drink to the idols. For which thing? وَإِنَّ هَذِهِ الْأَصْنَامِ. And indeed, these asnam, these idols, يَا أَبِي, oh my father, لَا تَأْكُلُ وَلَا تَشَرَبُ. تَأْكُلُ comes from أَكَلَ. أَكَلَ يَأْكُلُ. We talked about this verse before. This is a review. So أَكَلَ means to eat. أَكَلَ. يَأْكُلُ. He is eating. تَأْكُلُ. هِيَ تَأْكُلُ. Means the asnam تَأْكُلُ. So they do not eat, they are not eating, وَلَا تَشَرَبُ, and they do not drink. تَشَرَبُ comes from شَرِبَ, يَشَرَبُ, to drink. وَكَانَ أَزَرُ يَغْضُبُ وَلَا يَفْهَمُ. And Azar, his father, the name of his father, was becoming angry, used to become angry. وَكَانَ أَزَرُ يَغْضَبُ. يَغْضَبُ comes from غَضَبَ. 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 باء يغضب غضب يغضب to become angry. And so his father used to become angry. وَلَا يَفْهَمُ يَفْهَمُ comes from فَهِمَ. This is a review. We talked about it last time. فَهِمَ means to understand. And so وَلَا يَفْهَمُ means هُوَ لَا يَفْهَمُ. He does not understand. So his father used to become angry and did not understand. وَكَانَ إِبْرَاهِيمُ يَنْصَحُ لِقَوْمِهِ وَكَانَ النَّاسُ يَغْضَبُونَ وَلَا يَفْهَمُونَ. And Ibrahim يَنْصَحُ. Again, this is the nasiha. So nasuha yansahu means to give advice. So Ibrahim used to give advice li to qawmihi. Qawm means people or nation. Li qawmihi to his people. Wa kana nasu, and the people, right, the nas, yaghdabuna wa la yafhamun, and they used to become angry and they used to not understand, and they did not understand. La yafhamuna. So hum yafhamuna, hum yaghdabuna. So they used to become angry and they used to not understand regularly. قال إبراهيم أنا أكسر الأصنام إذا ذهب الناس وحين إذا يفهم الناس. So again, أنا أكسر. قال إبراهيم أنا أكسر. أكسر comes from كسر يكسر. كسر means to break. يكسر is the present tense form of it. So قال إبراهيم أنا أكسر الأصنام. I am going to. So again, أكسر. You don't necessarily need to add seen and sofa in order for a present tense form to indicate future tense. The present tense also indicates future tense as well by itself. But seen and sofa are used to specify immediate or distant future. Aksiru just means future altogether, generally. So it can be used for present and future. So, قال Ibrahim, and Ibrahim said, أنا أكسيرو, I am going to break the idols. إذا ذهب. إذا means when. So, when, okay? So, when إذا ذهب. ذهب means to go. ذهب يذهب. ذهب يذهب means to go. Okay? And ذهب الناس. Again, ذهب. ذهب means to go. الناس. الناس is plural. But because the verb comes before the subject of the verb, remember, the verb only needs to match the subject in gender, but not in plurality. You could choose to do ذهبوا الناسو because الناسو indicates plurality, but because ذهب comes before الناس, the subject, then all you need to do is match it in masculinity, not in plurality. So when the people have left, when the people have gone, all right, have gone, وحين إذن and حين إذن. حين إذن means at that time, at that time, and it's going to be in this form. Hina idhin will always be in this form, and it's used to mean at that time, at that moment. Okay, and at that time, yafhamu nasu, the people will understand. Yafhamu an nasu. All right, number four, Ibrahimu yaksiru aslama. Again, I put the harakat here, but because you're familiar with yaksiru, you're familiar with asnama, you're familiar with the way that it's phrased, that you know you don't even need the harakat there. You can read it on your own. Ibrahimu is the subject, so it's Ibrahimu yaksiru, right? You know it's yaksiru al asnama, the idols. So as you get more familiar and comfortable with the language, you won't need the harakat, right? That's why you're able to pick up advanced books and read it without harakat. وجاء يوم عيد ففرح الناس. جاء means to come. Okay? وجاء means to come. جاء means to come. Okay? يوم عيد. What's coming? The day of عيد. And يوم عيد is a possessive compound. يوم عيد. The day of festivity. The day of festivity came. So the day of festivity arrived. ففرح الناس. ف means wa. Means and فرح الناس فرح يفرح فرح يفرح. Okay, فرح يفرح means to be excited, to be happy, to be celebrating and to be joyous. And the people were excited and they were enjoying themselves and were happy and were jubilant, right? And the people were jubilant. وخرج الناس للعيد خرج يخرج. Kharaja means to exit or to leave, okay? So, kharaja nasu lil'id. And the people left or the people exited the town for the festival. وخرج الأطفال. And who else left? The أطفال. أطفال comes from طفلٌ. طفلٌ means baby or child, right? أطفال is the plural of طفل. And the children left as well, exited. وخرج والد إبراهيم. And the father of Ibrahim left, exited. And he said, وقال لإبراهيم, to Ibrahim, ألا تخرج معنا? So this isn't the first time we've encountered this ألا, this أه. What's going on here? Well, if you just have تخرج معنا, means you are exiting معنا, with us. It's a statement, right? A proclamation. You are exiting with us. But if you add, there's two harf, حروف. They're called harf al-istifham, حروف al-istifham. The حروف of questioning. هل and a. If you add هل or a to the beginning of a statement, it becomes a question. So تخرج معنا means you are exiting with us. هل تخرج معنا means are you exiting with us? Same thing. A تخرج معنا means are you exiting with us? So if we look at this statement here, ألا تخرج معنا? Are you not, because لا means negative, are you not exiting with us? قال إبراهيم, إبراهيم said, أنا سقيم. I am sick. سقيم means sick. Now what is إبراهيم saying here? Well, obviously إبراهيم is not lying, because he said this so that he could stay behind and destroy the idols. But we know that Ibrahim is not sick in reality. But what he's saying externally has one meaning and internally has another meaning to him. He's sick of shirk. He's sick and tired of the shirk and the ubudiyah of idols. So he is really sick. He's not lying. But externally it meant something to his father and it meant something different to himself. So he said, I'm sick, so I'm not going with you guys. وَذَهَبَ النَّاسُ. And the people left and the people went. ذَهَبَ means to go. And the people went, wa and baqiya Ibrahim. And Ibrahim stayed behind. Baqiya, baqiya, yabqi. Again, it's another one of those verbs that has a ya in it, so it's a complicated verb. Baqiya, yabqi. So yabqi is the present tense. You just got to memorize that for now. So baqiya means to remain behind. And so Ibrahim remained behind, fil bayt, in the house. وجاء إبراهيم. And Ibrahim came إلى الأصنام, towards the idols. وقال للأصنام. And he said to the idols, ألا تتكلمون? Again, question. لا تتكلمون? Are you not speaking? أنتم لا تتكلمون? Are you not speaking? ألا تسمعون? Are you not hearing? And then he goes, هذا طعام وشراب. Remember, هذا is the masculine form of ism al-ishara, which means this. What's the feminine form of this? Hadihi. What's the distant form of the of hadha? Thalika. What's the feminine form of thalika? Tilka. Okay? This is ism al-ishara review. Hadha ta'amun wa sharamun. This is food and drink. Ala ta'akulun? Are you not eating? Ala tashrabuna? Are you not drinking? وسكتت الأصنام. سكتت comes from سكت. سكت is the root. سكت يسكت is a present tense. So سكت يسكت means to be quiet or to remain silent. So it's actually سكتت. سكتت فعلت. فعلت means هي, right? هي فعلت. Sakatat means, and the reason why it's sakatat is because al-asnamu is non-human plural and it acts like hiya. But then why is it sakatatil asnamu? Well, it should be sakatat, but because you have a sukun here and a sukun here, you cancel this sukun, and for pronunciation purposes, you continue with a kasra. So sakatatil asnamu. And the asnam, the idols, remain silent. Li'annaha. What is li'anna? Well, لِأَنَّ الْأَصْنَامَ, let's say we use this phrase right here. لِأَنَّ means because. But it's a word that's connected, it's always connected to an ism after it. So because what? Because the idols. What happens to the word after it is that it takes the state of nasab. So we have a fatha here. So because the idols, something about the idols, whatever, after it. In this case, the word after it is a attached pronoun. So it's li'annaha, because they, right? Ha is referring to the asnam, the idols. Because they are hijaratun, are stone. Hijaratun means stone. La tantiqu. Tantiqu comes from nataqa. Nataqa yantiqu. Nataqa means to make sound. So la tantiqu means they do not make sound because they're stone. So wasakatat al-asnamu. The idols were quiet, remained silent, because they are stones. They do not make sound. لا تنطقوا. قال إبراهيم. And Ibrahim said, ما لكم لا تنطقون. So ما لكم is a phrase, is an expression. It's like كابته. What's wrong with you? And you can say ما لك. Or you can use any ضمير here. ما لك. What's wrong with you? ما لك. What's wrong with you? ما له. What's wrong with him? ما لهم. What's wrong with them? So ما لكم. Like, what's with you? That's really what it means. So ما لكم. What's wrong with you? لا تنطقون. Why are you not making sound? You're not making sound. What's wrong with you? You're not making any sound. These are not questions that he's trying to figure out. No, he's being... this is... What do you call it? Making a statement with the question. وَسَكَتَتِ الْأَصْنَامُ. And they remained quiet. وَمَا نَتَقَتْ. Okay, so it's showing another way of doing negation. Remember, ma here is the same as la. But ma turns a past tense verb into negative. So la is for present tense verbs. Ma is for past tense verbs. So ma nataqat. They did not make a sound. Hina idhin. Remember, what does hina idhin mean? It means at that time. At that time, at that moment, ghadiba Ibrahimu. So if you go back to ghad, it's actually not ghadaba, it's ghadiba. This should be kasra. Ghadiba yaghdabu. Okay? Ghadiba Ibrahim. Ibrahim became angry. Right? Wa akhadha al-fa'sa. And akhadha. Akhadha means to take. Okay? Akhadha ya'khudhu. Akhadha ya'khudhu. And this should be sukun. يأخذ أخذ يأخذ. Okay, so أخذ means to he took. So أخذ he took. الفأس the axe. فأس means axe. فأس means axe. وضرب إبراهيم الأصنام. Okay, now we're going into our old school grammar, right? وضرب زيد عامرا. Right? وضرب means he hit إبراهيم الأصنام. The idols. Ibrahim is the one doing the action. You know that because it's in the state of Rafa. Al-Asnam are the ones receiving the action. You know that because of the Fatha and it's in the state of Nasab. The object of the verb. Bil-Fa'asi. With the axe. Wa-Kasara al-Asnama. Wa-Kasara. And he broke the idols. Taraka. What does Taraka mean? Taraka means... Taraka... Yet, ruku means to leave something behind, to leave something. Taraka yet ruku. So in Ibrahim, wataraka Ibrahimu as as-sanam al-akbara. So he left the sanam. Sanam again is the single of asnam. It's the idol al-akbara. This is an adjectival compound, and al-akbara is not kabir al-kabiru. It's not the big idol, it's the biggest idol. Al-Akbara means the greatest or the biggest idol. So he left the biggest idol. وَعَلَّقَ وَأَنْ عَلَّقَ عَلَّقَ يُعَلِّقُ. Again, this is an enhanced verb, meaning there's extra letters to the root. So, عَلَّقَ. And they have special rules, which we'll learn in the future. But this will just help you build your bank right now. يُعَلِّقُ عَلَّقَ يُعَلِّقُ means attach something. So وَعَلَّقَ الْفَأَسَ, and he attached the axe في عُنُقِهِ to in, fi means in, عُنُق, عُنُق, means his neck. Okay? عنق. عنقه. في عنقه. And he here goes back to الصنم الأكبر. Okay? So he attached the axe to its neck. Right? To its neck. To the neck of the biggest idol. So Ibrahim left the biggest idol. He didn't break it. And then he attached an axe to the idol's neck. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت وأستغفرك وأتوب إليك.